The title of my sermon this morning is called Murder in the Sanctuary. And that word sanctuary, during the course of my sermon, will refer first of all to the sanctuary of the church, such as we are in this morning, and the activities associated with it. It will secondly refer to the sanctuary of our homes, and finally, to the sanctuary of the individual's life. Near the conclusion of his message on the Mount of Olives, Jesus spoke these words to the surrounding crowd. "Go in by the narrow gate," he said, "for the wide gate has a broad road which leads to disaster, and many people are going that way." The narrow gate and the hard road lead out into life, and only a few are finding it. It is, I believe, a characteristic that is common to most of us, and certainly it is an attitude that is prevalent in our churches today, that one must not ask too many questions, that to doubt is some sort of a terrible crime, that to spend much time struggling with and thinking through our problems concerning our beliefs, our faith, is a dangerous business. The fact of the matter is that a good many of us live with the notion that to be a Christian means to be without conflict. So what we have done is propagate the idea that if a Christian does come upon a problem, if he does have some doubts, the only way to resolve this conflict is to have faith. Because after all, these things are mysteries, and we really shouldn't expect to be able to understand them. For this reason, we in the church, many of our teachers, our parents, and even some of our ministers, have made ourselves the most brutal and vicious assassins on the face of the earth. If there are those among us who, in contemplating the effects of Hiroshima or Nagasaki during the last war, or in contemplating the effects of the extermination of 6 million people in the Jewish faith, if there are those among us who are horrified by this destruction of human life, how much more indignant should we, the church, be over the millions of lives that we have and are snuffing out daily?